Hi everyone, I'm Stan Mallon. Welcome to Paranormal Yakker. My guest today is Nancy Tenz, a lifelong contactee of interdimensional extraterrestrial beings who has emerged as a significant voice in the realm of alien disclosure and spiritual awakening. Nancy Tenz, welcome to Paranormal Yakker.
Thank you. I'm so proud to be here. Thank you so much for having me.
My pleasure. Your life, Nancy, was transformed profoundly through the continuous extraterrestrial encounters you experienced. However, before getting to where you are now, your journey was marked by personal struggles. What were they?
They were the fact that I was having beautiful experiences as a young child because the world around me had not influenced me. And my first conscious memories were at 2 and 3. And when I would tell my mom and dad that there were beings in my room, they would just laugh and say, go back to sleep. You're just having a very vivid dream, et cetera, et cetera. So it was brushed off and I learned to brush it off. So what I struggled with was several things. As I got older to around junior high school age, and I had already figured out growing up in Tennessee, which is part of the Bible Belt in the South, that these things were considered demonic or either a mental health issue. So my parents point blank told me, if you talk about these kind of things around your friends or their parents or at Girl Scouts, church, other family members outside the immediate family, you will be labeled, ridiculed, and made fun of. So I learned to have to just suppress this and keep it bottled up, which is not an easy thing to do because basically, you know, even as I got older, my parents really didn't want to talk about that aspect of it. They still never really got past, like, you know, thinking it was dreams or something of that nature. You know, I had no proof. And, you know, it was just not accepted at all in that time frame. So as I got older, you know, many things occurred. And I noticed that the way that the interdimensional extraterrestrials started interacting with me was different because of I had developed insecurities. I had developed anxiety and started being scared because I started reading and listening to what other people were saying. So it changed my personal belief system into questioning what was happening around me. And so when that occurred and I started to feel anxiety, but they've always let me know about 10 minutes before they are going to manifest in the room with me. This gives me time to mentally prepare myself. But at this point and stage, through this age period for me, the fear took over. So when they would appear in the room, somehow or another, between that, it manifested the intensity of my fear more because they are at a much higher frequency than human beings are. So for me, it's never, ever been about what they look like. At that point, it was about the frequency exchange and the new belief systems that people had programmed into my mind. So I was experiencing extreme fear and anxiety and dread, but to make a long story short, these were things that I did within my own mind. These were nothing that they actually did. So I realized, you know, when I got in my 20s that this was going to continue. It was not going to stop. And I realized I had to work on my fear. And the way that I did that was I realized by gifting me the knowledge of them coming for 10 minutes, this was time. And it took me a while to figure out what they were doing, but they were giving me time to mentally prepare myself. So when I feel the frequency elevate in my body, I feel the change. I talk to myself, my inner subconscious. I tell my brain, we know what this is. This is not fear. This is the frequency exchange. This is what we have to face. This is what we have to battle so that we can continue through the whole experience with full consciousness. And I did not get it right. You know, it took me a while. It was a struggle for sure. And a lot of times I would get what I thought I was doing good, and then I would like have a relapse. But eventually I did get to the point. And so now when I have my physical face-to-face contact with them, I get to experience holding, touching hands, feeling the temperature of their skin, caressing and embracing them like I did when I was a little girl. So for me, that was not only was it something that they needed me to learn for myself, and I had to do it through the whole process. It wasn't something that they could quick fix for me. This is something and part of our evolution that all humans will have to do, is to learn to face the unknown, face our fears, and realize that just because there's things we don't know and understand does not make it be a negative experience or something that is truly an enlightened contact. So that's how it all began. And then so it just has increased. You know, I'm 64 right now, and it's far from being over. I have interactions with them either face to face or in my dream state or downloads all the time. And because that they showed me visions of where I made the choice to come to Earth and be part of this evolutionary process. So I chose to come here and be here. And they proved these things to me by opening visions and allowing me to see it. And then 2 years, to almost 2.5 years ago, they gave me a Kundalini awakening, which kind of just put everything in motion because it opened my subconscious up into my human consciousness. And everything that I ever questioned or needed to know, it all congealed and it all made sense. So I realized everything in my life that I've ever experienced, they had some direct input or relation or set it up for me because it was part of my soul plan as being here on Earth. And I had to experience these things because it has made me who I am today and able to come out and talk to humanity about what we're going through right now, why they are here, what their agenda is, what is the purpose, what does it mean? And I also know why I am here and why I chose to come to do this. And that I also know that my two sons, who are my sons here on Earth, I don't know what their relation to me was as interdimensionals, but we all three were interdimensional extraterrestrials, and we all chose to come here and be part of this to support and be here for each other to deal with all these challenges. And basically, I never had that when I was growing up, but I did witness my sons having their first contact when they were very small. So I've always known that they were a part of this, but that was the only experience that I ever witnessed, and I was not a part of that. They put me in a sleep paralysis, and I observed them being taken and watched it. And then they blacked me out as they left with them. But now I know that my children have had many experiences, and we all talk about it and share information and help one another. And they also gifted my oldest son a Kundalini awakening about the same time they did me. We don't live together, so we didn't even know it had happened to each other, or I didn't even know what it was. It scared me to death. And my son, it didn't scare him like it did me. And he saw it as an awakening, I guess. But for me, I wasn't sure. And it took me a month to even talk about it. And when I did, that's how I found out.
After everything you went through and experienced, you became a staunch advocate of disclosure and concluded that now is the time when it should happen and that we'd be part of it. In that regard, you created Time for Disclosure. What, Nancy, is the mandate, the goals of that platform?
Well, when I started it, like any other human being on this planet, I started it 4 or 5 years ago, and that's just what, they probably told me to pick that name, timefordisclosure.com. My sons and I sit down and we discussed it, and I said, Time for Disclosure. And they're like, okay, that sounds good. So at that point, what disclosure meant and what it means now has evolved. It has broadened. I now realize disclosure is many, many different things to many, many different people. And for me, I now think when I started it was about the government disclosing all this information and, giving us the affirmation because, I grew up in a world where I could not talk about it. I grew up in a world where people laughed at me. I grew up in a world where you were considered demonic or considered a mental health, crazy. So at that point, when I started this, I was like, this needs to happen to help all of us to prove to the world we are who we are. But now, because of my direct more interactions and after the Kundalini awakening, I now realize that the purpose is about humanity. All of this, our evolution, our ascension, everything is tied together and part of this whole process. Disclosure is human beings, us understanding who we are, our uniqueness, understanding ourselves from the inside, understand who we are on the soul level, not what the world around us has programmed us into, because our world is changing and evolving. Our planet Earth is going through an ascension. We are going through it and we are changing. We are going to move out of this 3D negative realm into a more positive, higher consciousness and awareness, which means intelligence and also our visual ranges. In this 3D realm, we only use our five senses to understand the world. These things are going to change, not overnight. It has to be done in a very slow, divine way. And by the time we get to the end of it, it will seem like our world has always been this way. And it has to be done this way because this is about the whole world. This is not about me. This is not about the United States, not about any countries in particular. This is a worldwide phenomena, and we are all a part of it. We all made a choice to come to Earth, whether we remember it or not. They showed me how I chose to come here. All human beings on a soul level made a choice to come here and to be here at this pivotal moment in time, because this is the biggest leap since our creation. And we all, on a soul level, came to here to be a part of it and play a role. Whatever it is, we're all here for this reason. And that's why we are going through this ascension and evolution, because we are going to start to wake up and understand these things. So this is a big deal. I mean, it is big. This is a big, big deal. So it is about the world. And that's why I say, human beings, we are the disclosure. So now that is what disclosure means to me. It's about human beings. It doesn't matter what the government says or doesn't say. We're going to reach an intellectual level that all questions we want are going to be known, truths are going to come out, and we're going to remember things more on a soul level, the truths about things, and have better decision making. So what they tell me and have told me, because throughout the time, they give me more and more and more, just like with the world.
You, Nancy, have had encounters with beings across dimensions. Could you expand on those encounters, such as how were you transported to them, what you saw there, and how would you describe the beings who took you there?
Sure. Yes. When I was little, and up until at least a year ago, off and on, they do things differently depending on the region of where I am. I've not always lived in the same place. I've lived all over a bunch of different places. So, but when I was little, and sometimes now, I always have three grays that are the hybrid grays, and they are reddish brown. One is a female, and I am bonded to her, not only in this human life that I'm bonded to her, but she's been with me in my past lives. And she is like a guide or a, oh gosh, I don't even know the word. Some people call them different things, but for me, I love her. She loves me. So she's kind of like a guardian or a nanny or something like that. So anyway, I always have the same three, and they always travel in threes, and there's a lot of reasons for that. But when so she would come, and so she would take either her hand or use her higher consciousness, and she would vibrate my body, not touching me, but vibrate my body to a higher frequency, which would make me vibrate. And at a certain point, my body would start to float up off the bed. And then she would take me by the hand. And as she raised my frequency to match her frequency, then she would take me through my attic, through the ceiling, or take me through a window or a door. And I can remember going through the attic and seeing boxes and storage and looking around and seeing the unfinished floor, the planks, only a few planks up there to set boxes and the insulation. And I remember looking at her and going, "How are you doing this?" So what it was, she was just simply changing my frequency to match hers, and that I was able to travel like she did. And a lot of times, the craft would be nearby when they did it this way. And so I would see the craft, from a distance, and it would look about the size of half of an American football field. But then when we would get there and we would go inside, it was like walking into a whole new dimension. It was like whoosh. It was like humongous, humongous mothership, humongous. And but from the outside, it appeared much smaller than what it actually was. And then when I get on craft, I don't even see her or the other two until it's time to take me back home. And when I'm there, I go through a process. The process is saying a greeting, and then they do a thorough exam, which they check for to see if I have, if I'm healthy, if my human parts are working right. They check on my spiritual well-being. They check on my mental health. They check to see, how am I evolving on an evolutionary scale? How, are we, what toxins are we being exposed to down on earth? And then there's a group around me that's always studying or evaluating me, watching my interactions, listening to what I say. And I know some of them are actually my family because they live much longer lives than we do here on earth. So 64, I'm a baby to them. I'm nothing. And they're my family, and they're waiting for me to finish my mission here and come home. But so I know that they're there, but I make a point to try to make eye contact with them because I know that they're going to feel everything I feel, and I'm going to probably sense. Well, they're better at controlling themselves, but for me being human, they know that that would be very hard for me. So, they don't make me go through that right now because I am not ready to leave Earth. I'm a grandmother, a mother, a cousin, a daughter, a friend to many. And my life is not over here, and neither is my mission that I came here for. This is just the beginning. And I hadn't even written a book, but I will. But my experiences are far from being over. We're just getting going.
You have said, Nancy, that experiences often labeled as abductions are, in your understanding, enlightened contacts, part of a broader benevolent interaction with extraterrestrial entities aiming to usher humanity into a new era of cosmic participation. What led you to that understanding?
The fact that I've listened to many, I have the Facebook group. I have over 20,000 members in. I also have my website, timefordisclosure.com, and I have a forum for, and many members that subscribe to it. So constantly reading what they say. I'm constantly studying it, researching it. And that I'm constantly talking to the interdimensional and the tall grays and the all, there's many different races of gray. There's over 60 different colors, different heights. And I'm asking them all these questions because these are the questions that people want to know. And this is what I'm here for. So the way that I can explain it to you is that human beings, like I said, make agreements that we don't remember. When we come to Earth, whatever soul contracts we made, it is washed from our memory. We are brainwashed, or it is just blocked out. Our subconscious still knows these things, but our human conscious does not know. So these people do not know that they've made this agreement. And so they're strictly coming at it from the human perspective. And it is a scary thing, to not understand and to be around a being that has such a high frequency. Our brains doesn't know how to perceive that because it's the frequency exchange. It feels like extreme fear with extreme euphoria balled up into one. And it's like you don't know to feel good or scared to death, So because of us being all this programming, negative programming in the 3D realm, we assume that we need to be aggressive or fight or run or hide. We see it as like we would have back in the caveman days as a dinosaur. It's a threat. We feel like it's a threat, and that is a human nature thing. And they understand this. So, and they also know that we don't remember our soul contracts. So when they do these things, they're here for a task, an agenda. They're on their own mission. They do not have time to give you a class in psychology and history of your soul here on the planet. We are here to figure those things out for ourselves. So that's why when they sense all this, they black us out. And a lot of people have the missing time or have the fragmented memories. And when they become conscious, their brain sometimes will try to fill in this missing parts. And because they're trying to rationalize what occurred, and they will pull from whatever their belief system or whatever is in their brain bank, data bank of what they've read or watched on television, what movies or what they've been told, and they'll fill it in with that kind of information. And a lot of times, people eventually will come to the realization later that they misunderstood it. Some do not, but many have. So this is part of why we have to go through this evolutionary process to answer these questions. And we have to experience this on our own rather than somebody tell us, because until we walk it and know it, that's how we truly know it's the truth. So at the time that they were doing this, they knew we were fixing to have an ascension and an evolutionary leap in our timeline. So that's why they decided just to let us figure this out on our own. That's part of our spiritual growth. And that I think also that is why our government is so wishy-washy, where they're, it's like it got all started and then it kind of just, it's lax. They're not really doing anything and they're not being budged to do more. But I think they know what I know. Why come out here and freak the world out when you know that humanity is going through an evolutionary process, an ascension, and their awareness, their understanding, their intelligence is going to increase, where at a lower consciousness, they're going to be angry, mad, upset because we're still in this negative realm. So they're waiting, I think, till we get a little move more into the fourth dimension, and then it will be a lot more understanding and acceptable to the world.
My next question you sort of covered right now, but I'm going to ask it anyway in case there's another part of it. How, Nancy, do beings from faraway galaxies look at our planet and all the hate and turmoil that's currently taking place on it? And did they give you any clue as to if they intend to bring some needed humanity and spirituality to us and get us back on track? Or will they keep their distance and hope we come to our senses?
A lot of what you said is it's kind of all of that in a combination. And the way I can best explain this is that part of our evolution is us coming to the realization that old program negative ways no longer serve humanity. or if we stay in this negative 3D realm, we're looking at possibly destroying our planet and environment and some of the population on this planet due to misuse of our technology, just and also because we are being controlled in this realm. This is a realm where wars can occur, all negative aspects, racism, separation, division, people having difference of opinion and separation of religions. Politics is another example of it, separation. So they know that this is part of our human experience, and we had to experience the negative with the good, because that is what is going to make us who we were created to be. And we will, as we ascend, we will learn these old ways no longer serve us. And we want to be a generation that continues on, our species to continue on for billions of years, just like the interdimensionals and extraterrestrials. And if we follow that path in the right way, we will dismiss all this negative stuff little by little by little until it finally disappears. Does that mean that we'll ever be perfect? No, we're human beings. That doesn't mean we'll ever be perfect, but it means we can be better versions of ourselves, make better decisions, and continue on our civilizations for millions, billions of years if we use our technology, use our intelligence, and come together as one in unity and realize that there's been a certain group of human elites that have controlled our world, which put a limit on our lifespans, put a limit on our, it was a way of population control. And they kept us in a materialistic, greedy, keeping up with the Jones, so to speak, money-making process program, which didn't benefit us at all, but it did line their pocketbooks, because they've been sitting on technology that could have changed our quality of life a very long time ago, but they were greedy and decided to not let humanity have, we should not have poverty. We should not have diseases. We should have free energy. We should not be using fossil fuels. We should not be using synthetic pharmaceutical drugs that really aren't compatible with our body, because when we were created, everything we ever needed was put here in some form, whether it be plant, mineral, bark, flower, etc. It was all put here, and they're sitting on a lot of information and technology because they cannot make money, or they can, and they cannot control and manipulate healthy, intelligent people. So this is not only an evolution. This is a way that we will finally understand what freedom is. We've never been free since the day we were born. And this goes way back for eons for humanity. But we are the generation that could go down in history. We are the stepping stones to changing the world, changing the planet. And our generation could go down in history as being the one that made the change that needed to occur. We are the people the world has been waiting on, the universe has been waiting on, and our Mother Earth and every living creature on our planet has been waiting for us to wake up and make good decisions and make a difference in the world we live on.
Should the viewers of Paranormal Yakker want to learn more about your platform, a platform that encourages disclosure and with that the truth about alien beings visiting Earth, how, Nancy, can they do that?
Well, anybody that wants to come and visit any of the Facebook group, Time for Disclosure / We've Never Been Alone / We Are the Disclosure, because it is. It's us human beings. We are the disclosure, and we have to come together and work together and forget our differences and forget our old ways. We don't have to be ashamed of our old ways or angry or mad. Those are the things that have made us who we are. It is part of our history. It's part of who we are. So, but it's what we do now, the decisions we make now is what's important. So people need to look within, work on themselves, to be better human beings. And then once they do that, then focus on the outside things. But basically, they can come into these groups or, you know, find out links. There's plenty of meetup groups. There's plenty of podcasts just like you where they can learn these type of information, you know, and there's symposiums, conferences, you know, there's books, there's many, many things. So I try to provide links to many, many different things because it's good to have a variety because you get a perspective from many different people. And that's how we can pull all this knowledge together and make good, solid decisions that we're comfortable with.
Nancy Timms, I thank you for being my guest on Paranormal Yakker. It's been a wonderful experience yakking with you.
Thank you for having me.
Hi, everyone. This is Stan Ballard of Paranormal Yakker. I hope you enjoyed the interview you just watched. So that you don't miss any upcoming shows, be sure to subscribe to my free YouTube channel. To do that, just press the subscribe button on your screen.